Hello my dear students, welcome to my channel Learning Hub. Now, so agenda of this video is again few programs of manipulation. So we'll start with first program. So the first program is to create a tuple. You can see here the tuple should be like A, then BB, then CCC, which we have already done while I was covering the list topic. So that time we created a list with 26 copies of Z at the last. So same program, only thing is the list should be converted to tuple. As tuples are immutable, so always we will create a list, then we will convert it into in a tuple form. So we have taken a sky value because small a, from small a we have to start. Small a sky value is 97, and we have taken an empty list. Then we'll start with 1 to 20, no, total number of characters are 26. We'll start from 1 to 26 and we are going to append in the list CHR of x. As I've already explained before, that CHR is a function that converts a number to the character. The ASCII value of 97 is linked with the character A into I. Into I means this is replication, so it will be repeated I times. So initially the value of I is 1, so one time only, so A will be only 1 like this. Second time, and then we have incremented the value of 1 of x by 1, so the value of x will be 98 now, and then we are going to append this again. 98 means B replicated twice, means 2 times, then C 3 times, and so on. Then list will be created, and then finally we will convert it into a tuple. You can see here, and then we'll print it. I'll run this program, function F5. Here, this is the list which we created. You can see the square bracket, then finally we convert it into a tuple. So this is the tuple. So this was the first program. Second program is to count the number of pairs A and B in which A and B are even. You can see this tuple, it means 4 and 6 both are even, this is count will be 1. Then 8 and 4 both are even, the count will be 2. So in this case the count should be 2, because in this the two pairs, this and this, is even. This is the program. So in this case we have to access each and every element of the tuple, and then as this is nested subtuple, we will check this again, this tuple, whether both the elements are divisible by 10 or 2 or not. If it is divisible by 2, it means it is an even number. So we have first of all accessed each and every element of the tuple for t1 in t, and then first this element will come in t1. So t10 means this element, that is 1. t10 mod 2 is 0, it means it is an even number, and t11, that means this one. So both the numbers we are checking, if both the, we have used AND clause, you can see, if both the numbers are divisible by 2, it means it is the pair is even, so count will be increased by 1, otherwise count will be 0 only, and then it finally it will print the count. I'll run this program. You can see number of tuples having even pair is 2. Now the third program to print true if all the elements of tuple 1 are present in tuple 2. So we have to first take all the elements input from the user t1 and t2, then we will check whether all the elements in t1 are present in t2 or not. If it is present, then it will print present, otherwise it will print false. So first I'll run this program, then I'll explain it. Enter tuple 1, 2, 3, 4 suppose, and tuple 2 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So as these all the elements are present in this, it will print true, otherwise it will print false. Again I'll run this. Now suppose enter tuple 1, I am entering 1, 2, comma 3 in tuple 2. I am entering 3 comma 4. So you can see 1 and 2 is not present, so it should print false. So I'll explain this program. First of all, I have taken input from the user, then accessing each and every element of the tuple. Now you can see again here, we are not using the range function because we have to access element. There is no use of accessing accessing index of the elements of tuple. So directly we are using for t in t1. Now all the elements one by one will come in t. So if t in t2, in operator I have already explained, in checks the present of element in another element, in another data type, may it be list, may it be tuple. So it will check whether t is present in t2 or not. If it is present, so it will keep the value of present as true. Suppose if any one element is not present, so present will be turned to false and break, because once element is not present, we don't have to check it again. So it will break, then break is needed. If we will not use break, then what will happen? Suppose one element is not present, it will not break, and again it will go, the suppose second element was not present in t2. So it will, present will be false. And if we will not use break, in next iteration, suppose third element was present, so present will turn to true. That is why, so this output will be wrong. That is why it is mandatory to use break here. Now the last program is to find the mean of all the elements of the tuple. Again, we are accessing the elements, so we should not use range. We can use, it's not mandatory to use this in this form only, but if we are accessing element, it is easy for us to use for in this way, for I in t. So each and every event will come in I one by one, and sum was initially 0. So in first iteration, sum will be 0 plus whatever the value is, suppose 1. So now sum will be 1. In next iteration, sum is equal to 1 plus third element, fourth element, and so on. Finally, mean will be the sum of all the elements divided by length of tuple, that is mean. So I'll run this program. Enter numeric tuple 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 plus 3 7 7 plus 2 9 9 plus 1 10. 10 divided by 4, you can see 2.5 will be the answer. So my dear students, I hope all you understood all the concepts. If you like this video, please like and subscribe and hit the bell icon. Please share this video. Thank you and have a nice day.